Dear friends, my name is Hansraj Verma. I am a career bureaucrat belonging to the 1986 batch, and I have had a journey of 33 years in the bureaucracy. This journey has taken me across a wide spectrum, right from Titan. I was the chairman of Titan for two industries Tanishq. I was the EB chairman, long period turbines, then was the ENF secretary. Presently, I handle the rural development Panchayat Raj with an additional mandate of MSME for the last 5 months. Now, the subject given to me is downturn in MSME. How do you handle it? Friends, let me give you a very human perspective to this downturns and upturns in life. Once you have that perspective and context, then handling the various cycles of business should not be a difficult challenge for any of the entrepreneurs available in this hall. I'll tell you two stories. Anil Ambani, though the different context today, he used to weigh 100 plus, they say. And when they were negotiating some deal with an American company way back, after signing the deal, when they were to sign it, one of the negotiator told him, "Mr. Ambani, your company is in great shape, but what about you?" Seeing his health. And they say after that, Mr. Anil Ambani took to running marathons, reduced substantial weight, and is very good physical shape. These current travel business is a different thing today. But the key point here is, for any entrepreneur to handle the stress of business, the bottom line is health. If that is not with us, then we are constrained in handling the headwinds we face, whether in life or in business. The second story, this is in context of a spate of news items we have been hearing of late, of where successful businessmen have taken the extreme step and ended their lives, citing business stress. Now, can that be reason for taking the extreme step? Friends, just give some thought to that. Again, let me quote from the upcoming book of Jim Mattis, who is also called Mad Dog Mattis, General Mattis, the Defense Secretary of US, one of the most cerebral soldiers on earth today. His book is coming out in November. It's called Calls on Chaos. A small extract from that. He says, if you have not read hundreds of books, then you are functionally illiterate and you are incompetent. Your personal experiences will not give you the bandwidth to sustain in life, which means our limited world of balance sheets, profit loss statements, board meetings, audit meetings is just one small dimension of a total existence of a businessman entrepreneur. You have to increase your bandwidth if you want to sustain in life and do well. So friends, with these two stories, I feel the key ingredient today which we must inculcate in the young leaders, young business persons, is resilience, which I find, if you see the stories and the media reports, seems to be lacking somewhere. So in the grooming of the next generation of business persons, inculcating resilience to handle the headwinds of life has to be a mandatory part. And friends, resilience just cannot be bought off the shelf. It has to be through a very close system of mentoring. We need mentors in the system who can pass on these values to the next generation. Because any loss on any extreme step by a business person is a national loss. he or she is a national asset. How much wisdom is there in that person? How much experience is there in that person? Just living it overnight is a national loss. A national asset is gone. So this is where resilience comes into play. Now friends, coming to the MSME sector, I will not be in a position to comment on some of the policy stands of the government, both the federal government and the state government. But let me just take you across one very crucial partnership model with the Rural Development Department is doing with the MSMEs. We have identified the trade bodies, TANSTIA, CODISIA, HOSTIA, across the state. And now we are going to make them project implementing agencies. Now what does it mean? This is under the Rural Youth Skilling Program called the Deen Dayal Upadhyay Gramin Kaushal Yojana. It's a partnership scheme between Government of India, Government of State in 60-40 proportion. It's a very, very handsome budget. A budget of 1,000 crores is available with me. The basic mandate is train the youth in relevant skills, give them jobs which are sustainable. An average candidate, we spend about 1 lakh to train him in any skill of your choice, which is part of the national skill framework. Now, what is this partnership? Example, we have TANSTIA, or we say HOSURVE HOSTIA. HOSTIA members can become trainers themselves. We will fund you. You say you want 1,000 candidates to be trained from rural areas in Tamil Nadu in a specific skill. You take up the program and employ them. What government expects is just 70% of the candidates should be placed, and average salary should be the range of 12,000 to 15,000, which is very, very reasonable in case. This way, we help you out with the training budgets. Not only that, you get candidates who are trained in specific requirements and skills. Hi. Skills relevant and specific to your sector. It's a win-win for the government, win-win for the rural youth, win-win for the industry. So request SICCI to publish the scheme, yes. But we need trade associations. It is a very, very simple program in which you will get trained hands of your specific requirements. Because often you find this paradox. Youth in India, friends, India is a young country. Our average is 29 years of age. The youth is aspirational. The youth is angry. The youth is impatient. It is our bounden duty of all the stakeholders, the industry, the civil society, the government, to give them those skills which make them employable. Today, the biggest difference between China and India is the skill gap. It is here we should form strategic partnerships with the government and bridge the skill gap. The youth who come out of colleges should have that specific skill set which makes them employable on a sustainable basis. So I welcome all members of SICCI to come forward and partner with the Rural Development Department on this very, very promising Rural Youth Skilling Program. Yes. Now friends, what are the options, future growth for Tamil Nadu MSME? Any nation which is strong in aerospace and defense industries has a base of auto sector. From auto to aerospace and defense is the logical progression. We have the precision skills, the skilled manpowers. We have the physical assets for this transition. Government of India, under its Make in India program, the Ministry of Defense Production have identified two defense corridors. One in UP, the Agra-Kanpur belt, and the second one is in Tamil Nadu, with 5 nodes, Chennai, Salem, Hosur, Trichy, and Coimbatore. Now, each of these nodes has got a very, very specific strength which will enable the transition to defense and aerospace requirements of the nation.
Yes.
Take example, Trichy, BHEL. They are masters in this heavy metal welding for the ship hulls, submarines, components. Yes. Coimbatore, with its precision engineering for the electronics, avionics of the fighter systems. Yes. Salem, with the strength in textiles, for the technical textiles, the uniforms, the parachutes, and other requirements of the armed forces. Yes. Hosur, the proximity to Bangalore in this aerospace sector, and Chennai with the auto sector and its huge intellectual capital in terms of IIT Madras, Anna University, other institutions, is rightly positioned to capitalize on this. So friends, again from SICCI, please partner with the government of Tamil Nadu, the Industries Department, MSME Department, CIDCO, for positioning ourselves in this defense industry corridor. The next edition, the 11th edition of the Defense Expo, is from 8th February to 11th February in Lucknow. Government of Tamil Nadu, the Industries Department, MSME Department will take huge space in this and position our MSMEs for this Defense Expo with their specific strengths. We're going to have huge number of buyers coming across the world. So please note these dates in your diaries, and as MSME units, please participate in Defense Expo. The next critical component for MSMEs is credit. Friends, in my capacity as a Rural Development Secretary, I am also designated as the Mission Director for Financial Inclusion. I have a very clear mandate for the Jan Dhan Yojana, for the self-help groups bank linkage program. We used to be stagnating at 6,000 crores for several years. Last year, we have jumped to 12,000 crores. And this year, we plan to do 15,000 crores of bank lending to the SHGs, self-help groups, with an average ticket size of 6 lakhs. This kind of money pumped into the self-help groups will revive the rural economy, give a boost to the rural consumption, and drive enterprises. It will be interesting to know that the NPAs, which you keep hearing in the press, for the self-help groups is only 2%, friends. All the loans to the SHGs are through our nodal agency, the Tamil Nadu Women Development Corporation. So any of the SICCI members, as a part of your CSR, as a part of your social outreach, please partner with the Tamil Nadu Women Development Corporation, which is the custodian, the trustee of the huge social capital of Tamil Nadu. About 6 lakh groups, both across rural and urban areas, are with this organization. About 1 crore membership of women. This is the social capital of Tamil Nadu. This is the strength of Tamil Nadu. And Tamil Nadu was the pioneer in this movement of SSG movement. Our Honorable CM is a keen proponent of the SSG welfare. I was discussing with some leading experts in one of these microfinance conferences. They say several states started together in the late 90s, late 80s. Why did Tamil Nadu do well? The common answer across the board was, it was the passion and empathy which a foreign minister, Dr. Jayalalitha, had for the women. It was her passion and empathy which laid the firm foundations of a very strong movement. And our present CM is carrying this movement forward. So please partner with the government of Tamil Nadu for any of your social outreach programs. We have crossed the first stage of development, that is financial literacy for the women. Next stage is enterprise creation at the village level. Tamil Nadu is very rich in agro-processing, local handicrafts. We want to create jobs at the local level, because jobs at the local level are sustainable areas. Migration to cities should be avoided, and for migrant labor, city is not the ideal option. If you can create those village level enterprises and give them reasonable incomes to sustain the lifestyles, this is the way forward. In this context, SICCI members, rural tourism is going to be a big wage job creator. Tamil Nadu has got history, it's got culture, it's got local cuisines, it's got the landscapes, right from your coasts to the hills, it's got the biosphere reserves. Today, the maximum footfalls of tourists is in Tamil Nadu, when you compare all the states. But the tourist of today, he wants immersive experiences. He just does not come to Chennai and stay in a hotel. He wants to go to the villages, live the life there, and go back and tell a story to tell. So this rural tourism with homestays is an excellent business opportunity and the way forward. As our management guru C.K. Prahlad late has mentioned, the fortune is at the bottom of the pyramid. So these kind of partnerships with SAG movement, rural tourism, local enterprises is a good business option for all the young entrepreneurs. In my interaction as Mission Director of Financial Inclusion with the PSC banks, I keep telling them, see the aggressiveness of the private sector banks, ICICI, HDFC. They are pushing very aggressively for this bank linkage program for the SHGs. It's a very good value proposition with the NPA of just 2%. And they see a lot of business opportunities. As a part of my mandate for financial inclusion, I am also the part of the State Level Bankers Committee. I am also the part of the RBI's Committee for Credit for the MSMEs. So friends, in any of these meetings, we plan to that along with this SHG bank linkage review, we also plan to take up the issue of credit to the MSMEs. In every such future meetings, this will be a very specific agenda. Okay, what are the issues? What are the constraints? And one common factor I found across is that the cutting edge is the BM level, the branch manager level. We need to sensitize the branch manager officers, plus give them a comfort level that this is a good value proposition for lending to the MSMEs. Days to come, the State Level Bankers Committee will be reviewing very closely the credit flow to the MSMEs. So friends, with these words, I seek partnerships with SICCI and wish you all the very best. Thank you.